Every morning, when I start my practice sessions, I do some very simple exercises, but they have to be at a very high quality. So long notes, very slow sequences of notes, listening to whether my sound is clean, whether it's round, whether it's centered.
Hij is geboren in Zwitserland, verhuisde al snel naar Duitsland, woonde even in Australië, ging studeren en werken in Italië om 3 jaar geleden naar Rotterdam te komen.
I live in a permanent identity crisis because I don't know where I belong to, but I like to believe that I belong a bit in different places in Europe.
Julian, of sinds zijn 5e Giuliano, is eerste trompetist van het Rotterdams Philharmonisch Orkest. In Rotterdam voelt hij zich thuis.
Not only think it's a fantastic city, but the mentality of the city, which is very down to earth, hardworking, always kind and very positive, although very direct and, you know, just very spontaneous, also exists inside the orchestra, and I very much identify with this way of being.
Het orkest is neergestreken in de grootste badplaats van Italië, Rimini. Het 15 kilometer lange strand trekt zomers ontelbare toeristen. Nu, begin september, lijkt het hoogseizoen achter de rug. Voor de 70ste keer wordt dit jaar in Rimini het Sacra Musicale Malatestiana Festival georganiseerd. En het wordt een spannende avond voor Giuliano, want op het programma Petrushka van Stravinsky.
I love it. It's probably one of my top 3 favorite pieces. And I remember that when I was a little boy, I only tolerated Bach, any Bach, and Petrushka. There is not a single moment which is kind of boring or a bit low energy. Fantastic ideas going on all the time. You have a very primary role in this piece as a trumpet player. And for me, the biggest challenge is to not lose the focus. Although the music is wonderful, there are almost no moments where I can just sit back, relax, and listen to what's going on, because I have to be very, 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 very concentrated.
Een paar jaar geleden had Giuliano zo'n groot en ingewikkeld stuk waarschijnlijk niet aangedurfd. Hij was uit vorm. Zijn techniek liet hem in de steek.
To be honest, whenever you are in a crisis or whenever you are struggling with difficulties in your life, often I think it's quite normal to question whether all this is worth it, because when you have really bad days, you think, okay, I've been doing this for almost 20 years since I'm a little boy and still I'm having such a hard time doing it. Should I actually do it? Do I want to go through this stress and to this emotional insecurity and struggle? Thanks to my colleagues' support, who gave me a lot of trust and, you know, sometimes forgiving little mistakes when they were happening, actually helped me completing the development of the correction of this structural weakness, and I feel much more confident about it now. At least I know how to solve it, how to manage it, and I feel much more, much better now doing my job on the position which I am on. Sometimes I try to just stay a little bit cool and not less passionate and not less warm-hearted, but try to be a little bit distant from the emotional part, so I make sure I don't get too involved with it.
I think it was quite nice. Feeling on stage was like it was quite tight, it was quite together, and everybody was very focused. There are always things you can do better, you know. Live performances are fantastic because it's never sterile, it's never perfect to a point that you say, okay, I never need to play it again because that was the version. I'm just gonna try to play as good as I can next time and enjoy as much as today.